Hello students, welcome to video lecture on web technology and its applications. This is the course overview and course outcomes. In last class we have seen about forms. Let us going to look into this is how a form interact with the server. You know that the request is sent to a server. Server returns the document that contains a form. Then it is user fills in the form and submits the form. Again a request is sent to a web server. It processes data and then services back the user, that is the client. Okay, so here we will look into how data is sent, that is by using a query string. What is that query string? That I will explain you. We have seen the example of this. For this text box, we have given the name as title. Okay, so I enter here as Central Park. We have another text box as country whose name was where, WHERE. Name we are given for that is where. Okay, in this we have entering United States. How this data is sent to the server is in this form. Name of the element, that is title here, is equal to whatever we have typed here, Central Park. But you can observe one change, that whenever we are using a special character, like space is used in between, that is replaced with plus. Okay, and when you are submitting multiple elements data, that is the data that we have entered in title as well as country text box, then in between the data is combined with ampersand. Okay, then again the name of the form element which we have used for creation of country text box, the name I given is where, right? So that is United States, right? So United instead of white space, plus is used. Okay, so this is the way the data is sent to the server. This way the name of the element and the value we entered, whenever we get a special characters like space, plus is used. For other than space, like if I am using a percentage or something like that, it's ASCII character preceded with the percentage symbol is inserted here, not the symbol is sent as it is. Okay, so this is about query string in short. Fine. So URL encoding we'll see now. You just observe here, this is one form. This is explaining you about usage of a special symbol. As you can observe, URL are encoded in red, percentage E9, apostrophe is used here. Can you observe? As I told, space is replaced by plus Pablo plus Joe's. Before E, there is apostrophe. So for apostrophe, what it is doing is percentage symbol is used, and what is that? ASCII code of apostrophe is converted into hexadecimal form in a two-digit form, and that is entered. Again, followed by that, you have a space. This way, it is encoding the query string, and this is attached with the URL. When it is attached to the URL, that we will see in the next slide. Okay, so form element, I'll talk about form tag here. So we have used mainly two attributes. I told I'll explain about those two attributes later. One of them is action. So as I said, action attribute specify the URL of the server side resource, that is uniform resource locator of the server side resource, that will process the form data. This is where we are sending the data, and that is processed by the server side program. Then the method, in what way we are specifying the data to be transmitted. So that is how the query string data will be transmitted. We have seen the query string just now, that how the query string is constructed. Right? This is the form in which it is sent. It is encoded in this way. But how it is sent is decided by the method attribute. So there are two methods, either get or post can be used as a value. Okay. So what is the change that we'll look into here? If I use method equal to get, this query string is attached immediately after the path of the URL where you are submitting, right? Say for example, this is the way we are specifying the attributes of a form element, that is method equal to get is used, action equal to process.php. So we are submitting the data what we have entered here to process.http. So when you click on submit button, obviously it is submit, its path will be changed to the location of process.php. So including the method used, the get is the method slash process dot php. After that you are able to see a question mark to indicate this is the end of the destination file where we are sending. After that the query string is attached, you can see, right? In get method the query string is attached in the URL itself, right? So this you are able to see when you click on a submit button. Okay, when you do it as a method equal to post and you are sending to the same file, that is process.php, what it does is it is converted into a file where the file content will be like this, rather than appearance of that query string in the browser itself. So you can observe the change. This you are able to see, get method whatever we use, that we are able to see here itself in the address bar itself along with the URL, you are able to see what data you have entered into the form. Whereas in post method, this is sent as a part of the file, this is not visible, only the location is changed to process.php and one file is attached with that. That file will be having all these data. Query string is sent as a part of that particular file. So what are these informations, so that you can see, these all are headers, we say, right? You know that HTTP is a protocol, so every protocol is having a header. So header part is not having actual information, rather the information about what data we are going to send, that is stored here, right? We are sending to through post method, where we are sending process.php, what protocol we are using, HTTP, what is the version of that, 1.1, when we are sending, right? Who is the host, what is the host name, who is the browser, what is the browser through which it is submitted, what is the length of the data that we are sending, that is 47 bytes. This way header is created, which is not actually information to be sent, rather it is information about the data that we are going to send, and actual information is this query string. This is appearing as a part of the file which is submitted when method equal to post is used. So what is the drawback of sending it in the form of a get method? Is one is that data what we are sending is visible in the URL itself, so it is not secured. So it can be sent as a URL of the browser itself. So there is a limit of 1000 characters only, you cannot exceed that. Say if I am attaching a file here itself, okay, which is a larger, then you cannot send through get has a limitation of size. Whereas if you are sending it as a file, it is not visible, data is not visible to any other user, as well as you can send any amount of data. So that are the advantages of post method. But in form, if we are not using a method attribute, by default it is sent by get method only. Okay, so this is about get and post values of the method attribute. Okay, so you can observe advantages and disadvantages. Data can be clearly seen in the address bar in case of get. Data remains in browser history, you can view it anytime you want. Data can be bookmarked, you can save it, and whenever you want you can use it. Limit on the number of characters in the form of data written. Data can contain binary data in post. Data is hidden from the user. Submitted data is not stored in cache, history or bookmark. Okay, so these are the advantages or characteristics of get and post methods both. Okay, so we'll go for form control elements. We have seen some of these. So here is a list button we have seen. See, we have seen a submit button. Okay, but you can also have a general button like save and all. For that you cannot use submit, no? So you can have your own, you can define your own clickable button, and you can also assign a task to that, right? You can have a data list used with this is defined by HTML file. Field set, I told you, form, input, label, legend, these all we have told. I have told option, multi item list, this also I told. Opt group, it defines a related options in a multi item list. Select, I have told you. Text area, I was telling yesterday that if you want to type a large text, then a text area is needed, right? For that we use it. Okay, we will see the rest of the details about remaining part of HTML in a next video lecture. Thank you.